Welcome to the CorpVault channel. In this video, we created a series of questions for knowledge check. You have 10 seconds to answer each question. Please like, share, comment or suggest. Subscribe for more videos. And you can follow us on Instagram. Question 1. The correct answer is D. While performing full system recovery of the only domain controller in its forest, you select the primary option when you are restoring a standalone domain controller, or the first domain controller restored in the network. Question 2. The correct answer is C. The virtual server agent provides complete data protection and recovery for virtual machine data, including full VM backups, incremental backups, and synthetic full backups, with support for full VM recovery, as well as granular disk and file recovery. So, all the other options fit with the features of VSA, except the answer C. Question 3. The correct answer is B. Streams are logical data channels that connect the client data to the storage media. Commvault provides the ability to define multiple streams to run backups and restores in parallel, to improve the rate at which data can be written to or retrieved from the storage media. Question 4. The correct answer is B and D. If multiple reads are enabled on the disk, verify that the hardware you use supports multiple reads, else enabling multiple reads might degrade the disk read performance. You can use RAID disks, or disks that allow multiple simultaneous reads, which improves the performance of the backup job. Question 5. The correct answer is C and D. The third-party software or antivirus scanner installed on your system is modifying the files every time they are backed up. In this process, these files are picked up in the subsequent backups, increasing the size of incremental backups. Question 6. The correct answer is B or D. You can either edit the host's file with the entries of the comserve, or use the IP address of the comserve during the install. We personally think editing the host file is the best option. Question 7. The correct answer is D. You can use Commvault's one-touch bare metal recovery to recover a failed computer or to create a clone of a server. With one-touch, you can easily recover a computer by automatically rebuilding the operating system and all the applications on a new server that has either similar or different hardware. Question 8. The correct answer is E. All of these are critical components, and are essential and necessary for the operating system to come back after the restore of the system state. If you have excluded any critical system state components from the backup, you cannot use that backup for the one-tact recovery operation. Question 9. The correct answer is B. To successfully browse and restore NAS data on a NetApp file server, it is recommended to use the UTF-8 setting for volume language. If the volume language is not set to UTF-8, then foreign characters or Latin extended characters will not be displayed properly when the backup data is browsed. To restore these files or directories, the parent directory containing them will need to be restored. Question 10. The correct answer is A. You can configure up to 4 search nodes in an end-user search engine. Question 11. The correct answer is A. You can convert a physical machine into a virtual machine, and convert a virtual machine into a physical machine, using the one-touch backup data. Question 12. The correct answer is C. During backups, streams originate from the source file or application and are created by the data readers that is used to read the source data. Question 13. The correct answer is B. As the snapshots are being taken at the data store level, during recovery, individual virtual machines can be reverted back to the data store in the event of machine corruption. Question 14. The correct answer is D. Practically, you can set any number of data readers if your hardware supports the same. But if you set more than 10 data readers, then you see the warning stating the number of data readers is recommended at less than or equal to 10. Higher settings may adversely affect performance. Question 15. The correct answer is C. It is recommended to configure LAN-free backup for NDMP remote filer, so the tape device is typically connected to a remote filer, either directly or over SAN. We will end this video here. Let us know in comments how you did. Please hit the like button if you like this video, and subscribe to our channel if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.